Hey, what's up? It's Chris from Brooker Films, and in today's video, I'm going to talk all about the walk-by transition. So let's get into it. The walk-by transition is a fun and relatively easy effect that can be used to transition from one shot to another. Now, when you're filming the footage to complete this effect, you simply just need to place your camera onto the ground, walk in front of the camera and walk from screen left to screen right or from screen right to screen left. And that's it. So to complete this effect, we're going to launch Adobe After Effects. And as soon as we've loaded up Adobe After Effects, we're just going to start a brand new composition. So I'm just going to press this new composition button here, and I'm just going to call this walk by, and I'm just going to make sure that the width is 1920, the height is 1080, we have square pixels, and the frame rate is 23.976 frames per second. And then I'm going to press OK. Okay, so from here, we need to import our media. So I'm just going to go over to this project tab over here on the left. I'm going to double click, press import and file. Okay, so now that your two video files are on your composition, we need to make sure that they're stacked in the correct order. So you need your footage of the walk past on top and you need your other layer below. So this is our other layer and this is the layer that we're going to reveal. So I don't want this on the top, so I'm going to drag this down. And that's going to make sure that the walk by shot, and that's this one here, is on the top. Okay, so now we can go through the process of masking out this layer. So we're going to mask behind this second leg, this back leg here. So to begin with, I'm just going to pull that back to the very beginning where we first reveal the frame. And now we want to create a mask. So I'm going to go up to the pen tool. This is on the top bar here. And I'm just going to draw around this white space here. Okay, so as you can see, this is going to get really difficult if there's a big black space over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to duplicate this top layer by pressing Command C and V. And then I'm just going to take the mask off that bottom layer. So I'm going to get rid of that. And then I'm just going to make sure that we lock this layer so we don't add any mask to this layer because we want to put the mask onto the top layer. Okay, so now we need to start the animation. So I need to create a new keyframe. And to do that, we need to click on the time stopwatch. So I'm just going to press here, and that's just created a brand new keyframe. So from here, I'm just going to go across a few frames, and I'm just going to advance that mask on to fill in the rest of this space here. So I'm just going to drag this one across here, I'm going to drag this one down, and that's perfect. And now I'm just going to do the same thing, move across to here, and I'm just going to drag this one across to here. And then I'm going to drag this one down to here. From this point, we're going to get rid of the layer below, and that was our reference layer. So we're going to make sure that we unlock this, and then we're just going to get rid of that layer. And now what has happened is this is now revealing the space that we wanted to get rid of, and it's deleted the space that we wanted to keep. So we're just going to go back into our mask. And we're just going to press the inverted box here. And that's just going to invert and flip the mask around. So now if we toggle the layer below, this is what we're going to see here. That is basically the effect, but it looks a little bit too messy for my liking. So for this, I'm just going to clean up a few of the edges. And as you can see here, this is just a really harsh line. And you can really tell that this has been masked. So I'm just going to adjust the feathering of this mask. So I'm going to go back into this layer. I'm going to go back into the mask. And I'm just going to pull the feather up to around 30, maybe 40%. Okay, now one last thing, I'm just going to add some motion blur into this effect. So I'm just going to make sure that we go onto our toggle switches modes. We're going to press that, and we're going to press this motion blur button here, and we may as well throw it onto the layer below. And then we need to activate it on the composition by going over to this motion blur button here and just turning this on. Okay, so that's it. That is the walk-by transition effect complete. And this is a fairly simple effect. When you utilize it correctly, it can look really cinematic and it can really help to add a lot of style to your films. If you enjoyed watching this video, then please do let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe if you would like to see more videos like this one in the future. Thank you ever so much for watching. I really do truly appreciate it. I hope you're having the most amazing day today. I will see you next time.